So, I got a number of comments in support of the idea that Billy isn't actually a pre-war ghoul, but a post-war one, dismissing the assumption that he's over 200 years old. So, to start a new series, allow me to introduce Theory Study, where I take a look at some fan theories, at the evidence for and against, and grade them on a scale. Is Billy a post-war ghoul? So the theory, which I've heard time and again, is that Billy was actually born well after the Great War, and only recently became ghoulified during the Quincy Massacre. Basically, it assumes that the Quincy Massacre featured gunners using Fat Mans to nuke the town, and Billiards hid in the fridge to save his life from the attacking gunners and became ghoulified from the event.
How did you end up in there?
I hid in here to get away from the bombs.
This would, by a timeline, put him closer to Fallout 2's Coffin Willy, who was buried in Golgotha for months, rather than the 210-year time span between the Great War and the release of The Sole Survivor. Is there any evidence for this theory? There isn't much. What evidence there is mostly circumstantial, which is a form of evidence, but not very solid, at least not on its own. One is that the Quincy Massacre did happen. It's why you find Preston and friends fighting off some raiders at Concord.
Just folks looking for a new home, a fresh start. I've been with them since Quincy.
The Quincy Massacre featured gunners blowing the support of a highway to build a ramp and fire down at Quincy over the town's defenses. You can also ask the Fridge Fiend if he's been in his extra small apartment for over 200 years, and he says he has no idea.
The bombs were over 200 years ago. You're that old?
I don't know how long I've been in here. A long time, though. A really long time. Please, I don't want to die in here.
Deniability in that statement. And for what it's worth, at least one Quincy gunner does have access to a Fat Man, Sergeant Baker. Also, he has a missile launcher, because he's extra like that. What about the evidence against? The evidence against mostly comes from dialogue. For starters, the Khan Ghul Prince is unaware of what ghouls are.
What happened to you? You're all burned up like me.
We're ghouls, Billy. The radiation changed us. Looks like it did the same thing to you.
While it's possible his post-war time at Quincy is incredibly sheltered, it's highly unlikely that the average wasteland child would not know what a ghoul is. Learning how Matt and Carol, his parents, became ghouls is probably the strongest piece of evidence against the theory.
We didn't make it to the shelter in time.
The door was shutting as the bombs fell. We both must have taken a lot of radiation.
I guess we were some of the lucky ones. Most folks die instead of becoming ghouls. Must be something in both our genes.
So that's why you guys look like me.
Yeah, Billy. That's why. Although it's really more why you look like us.
We wandered for a while, but eventually came back here. We've been living here ever since. Not really anywhere else to go.
They basically tell you that they didn't make it into a shelter in the time nuclear bombs dropped. The bombs, specifically. Notably, every other time when the bombs are brought up in this franchise, they're referring to the Great War.
It was to have been hand-delivered to me here at the Lucky 38 the next day. But the bombs fell first.
He is the great emancipator. He freed all the slaves over 100 years before the bombs dropped.
We were young. We didn't know what had happened, really. We didn't understand about the bombs.
The bombs were over 200 years ago.
In addition, they also state they wandered around for a bit and eventually came back to living in Quincy. While it's possible they did all of that within a year, the way to describe it does sound like it's at least a multiple-year journey. Besides, I doubt they wander too far from home, if they hoped the hide-and-seek champion would show up. Maybe after a few years, yes, but a couple of months? Doesn't sound too likely. There's a few more context clues in their dialogue. They all seem to hint, without outright stating, that they're pre-war. More references to the bombs dropping, a vague yet confirming statement of from before, and even saying that they lived this long. As a side, you can tell William the Frozen Pastry that his parents have been dead for hundreds of years, which he can believe if you land a successful speech check. But I'm not sure if that really counts as evidence, given he's not aware of how long he's been in the fridge. At best, it's supplemental. So, How strong is this theory? Here's her chart if I were to grade it based solely on the evidence. I say it's between bunk and very unlikely. There is a little bit of wiggle room based entirely on annoying descriptions and playing with words, but really not that much. I feel like Carol is stating the bombs is quite definite. Them rushing to a shelter specifically built for nuclear safety is also another strong piece of evidence. Now, they don't quite say a vault, I will admit that, but Vault 88 is pretty close to Quincy and the Peabody home, even if it's incomplete. It's not really common practice for post-apocalyptic fallout to have a shelter given most of the bombs have already been set off. I do think this theory is pretty close to bunk, but given that the Peabody's never specifically state before the war or something to that effect, there's enough wiggle room to ignore everything else and have your own headcanon, but I think it's pretty clear what the intent was. From those strangely ambiguous yet definite statements of bombs and before, to Billy being unaware of what a ghoul is. To suggest that Billy isn't pre-war is really just ignoring the evidence in favor of a different reality, based on a pretty flimsy premise. But I think this comes from a desire to forgive the quest as it was pretty controversial. While we have examples like the aforementioned Coffin Willie, who also calls important lore into question, is not nearly the same degree as Billy. It's still dumb, don't get me wrong, but not 200 years dumb. It's a few months dumb, based on what Coffin Willie says. I think when specific things are built on such a ridiculous foundation, but still enjoyed, people try to reject it and substitute it with their own ideas, which usually have the backings of hindsight to help them. That all being said, this quest was meant to be a joke quest, not meant to be taken seriously, as Pete Hines so helpfully wants to remind us. But for the lore nut crowd and the people who dislike specific ideas, it does get a lot of attention, but maybe it's a bit too much attention. Maybe.